This is the 10th how-to video in the range AMS 5 tech videos. This time we introduce our fingerprint reader as a solution for more secure authentication in areas that need better protection. We go to the office of Rojo Security and follow a discussion between the CEO, Charles Smith, and the IT specialist, Jet Chan.
Hi Jet. As you know, we have one office in our building where business-critical information is stored. I actually want to give only Sukiyo and myself access to this area. Do you know a solution for me to achieve this?
I think we can only achieve this with a biometric solution because we can then capture and validate a unique characteristic of you and Sukiyo. There are several solutions for this, but my preference is fingerprint validation because it is very reliable and relatively easy to implement. And this feature is standard available in our AMS system. I would also advise purchasing an additional fingerprint reader to enroll these fingerprints.
Thanks for your advice, Jet. I will ask Sukiyo to create a purchase order. As soon as we receive them, you can install them for us.
Let's go for it. Seems like a fun job and an excellent solution.
No sooner said than done. The order has been delivered and Jet has connected the readers to a PoE switch in our network. And he can now start with the configuration in AMS. To ensure that the readers work properly with the most recent version of AMS, it is advisable to upgrade the readers with the firmware that comes with the current AMS installation. This firmware is a bin file and is located in the downloaded AMS install package under Add-ons, Advanced, Bioconfig, Firmware. Both fingerprint readers need an upgrade. Now that the fingerprint readers are up to date, we can start to configure them for their application. The first scanned reader whose IP address ends in 116 will become our access reader. That's why we need to set the card type, data type, interface, and logical address correctly. The reader scanned second and whose IP address ends in 117 will therefore become our enrollment reader. Because this will only be used for registering fingerprints, we do not need to configure anything else. Now we have to go to the AMS configuration to first add the enrollment reader so that we can read the fingerprints. All we have to specify here is the type and IP address. If the port has not been changed in the previous fingerprint reader configuration tool, it will simply remain 51211. Now we can go to the personnel section to actually enroll the fingerprints there. Charles will start. He wants to have 4 fingerprints stored. Right index finger, left index finger, right middle finger, and left middle finger. Now Sukiyo. The other person authorized to enter office 5. Sukiyo finds it enough to successively enroll her right and then left index finger. This is how it works. First place your finger briefly on the reader, short beep, then lift it briefly and then place it back for a while, long beep. Until the green LED stops flashing. Now that the fingerprints have been neatly stored in the AMS database, we can configure the other reader that will grant the fingerprints access to Office 5. Let's create the entrance first. This takes us from the office building to Office 5. We can enter with the fingerprint reader, and we can leave the room with a push button. The fingerprint reader is now linked to the AMC controller via its IP address. Access to Office 5 is granted by a combination of a card and a fingerprint. Before we can test access, we need to modify the map view. On behalf of Office 5, we want to add the door and the fingerprint reader to the map. And we have to make sure through the filter that in the swipe ticker we can see Office 5 access incidents. We ask Sukiyo to present her badge and one of her two fingerprints. And if Sukiyo is subsequently granted access, we know that from now on we have dual authentication on Office 5. And therefore meet our previously set security requirements. Charles is happy with the application that Jet has implemented. He now knows that sensitive company information is only accessible to a selected group with scanned fingerprints. And this is the end of AMS 5 Tech video about dual authentication with fingerprints.